Sup's up, everyone. Wafy here. Today got this one right here. How a lack of confidence killed Shadow Warrior 2. Let's react to it.
It's difficult to criticize something that's intentionally stupid. It instantly makes you look like you don't get it, or like the joke went over your head. But just because something is trying to be dumb, doesn't mean it gets a free pass. Mad Max Fury Road is absolutely 100% fucking stupid.
Yep, but it's a weird masterpiece, somehow.
But it's also pure goddamn gold.
Yeah. What the hell is this? It's perfect.
That was stupid. But it's important to note that it's also, number one, fucking sick.
Yep.
And number two, impressive on a technical level. The amount of coordination, makeup, effects, work, and camera work that must have gone into that shot is mind-boggling. It's stupid, yeah, but it's also a technical and artistic achievement. Just because something is stupid doesn't mean that the people making it don't need to try. Being dumb and self-aware does not give you a free pass to just phone it in. It actually gives you an excuse to be as crazy and over the top as you want. Do you think this shit was easy to make? Do you think it's easy to get the camera, the stuntmen, the motorcycles, the goddamn horse all in the right position to make this scene work? There's no crazy CGI fuckery going on here either. Keanu Reeves had to learn to ride a fucking horse. Making something...
Damn, that shit was real.
That's both stupid and great. Takes talent, passion, hard work, Keanu Reeves, and above all, confidence in whatever stupid thing it is that you're making. But some people... sadly, lack the ability, the drive, or the commitment to make something truly dumb and truly amazing.
Let's begin.
Shadow Warrior 2 lays its cards on the table instantly. You start the game, and boom, rabbit sex. Alright, I've already gone almost 10 seconds without talking about Doom Eternal, so we're about 30 seconds overdue. In Doom Eternal, the opening cutscene isn't played for laughs. It's definitely stupid. I mean, there's a goddamn pentagram burned into the surface of the Earth, but it's played completely straight. This cutscene isn't here for no reason. It establishes stuff. It establishes that, number one, you're a badass. And number two, this shit's fucked. Go unfuck it. What does the opening cutscene in Shadow Warrior 2 establish? Rabbit sex. John Carmack, the creator of Doom and Quake and all-around beefcake, once said, "Story in a game is like story in a porn movie. It's expected to be there, but it's not that important." I don't really agree with this quote.
It's definitely not
a one-size-fits-all kind of thing, but I do think it's a valid approach to video game storytelling, particularly if you just want to be stupid. If you're going to take this approach, then go for it. Do what the original Doom did. Put a fucking text box at the beginning of each episode and call it quits. Don't constantly bombard me with painful cutscenes that do absolutely nothing when it comes to actually telling a story.
Intimidation is the tool of the fearful heart.
Hey, beats being the fool of the tearful fart.
Yes, I can skip them, but there's a lot of them. Not to mention Lo Wang constantly talks during combat, and it's fucking painful.
Stomping on demons who want all that snuggly, shooting at...
Will you shut up?
Pool of the tearful fog.
The hell up.
Damn.
Shut up.
This shit was on my wish list.
Uncle was Kaiser Soze?
Shut up.
Babysitters make good money.
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up.
I don't regret not buying it.
Yeah, you're playing as a guy named Lo Wang. Yes, I know, but we do not have time, okay? I'm still on the fucking rabbit sex. Obviously, his accent is about as funny as Song of the South. Now, this may shock you, viewer. You might want to take a seat for this one. But the voice actor for Lo Wang is actually not Asian American. His name is goddamn Jason Liebrecht, which I'm definitely mispronouncing, but honestly, who gives a shit? I'm not going to insult your intelligence. Either this accent pisses you off, or it doesn't. Honestly, it sort of pisses me off. It's not even that it's racist, so much as that it's painfully fucking unfunny. Just like the rest of the game.
You always make me smile, Lo Wang. No, wait, that's not it. You always make me fart. That's what it was.
If you laughed at that, click the dislike button and stop watching this video. I'm not being facetious, I do not like you, and I do not want you here.
Yep.
Now, here we are. It's already happening. This is the part where the, but it's supposed to be stupid defense comes in. And you know what?
Bro, no one likes shit like this. Like,
fine. This game markets itself as dumb fun action, which I'm all about, so I'm gonna mute the voices and just play it the way that God intended.
If the gameplay is good, then I might look over it.
But there's a problem with that. Much like there's too much story, there's also too much game. Jesus Christ, I sound like a fucking idiot. Hear me out. A video game is defined not only by what you can do, but also what you can't do. In Doom, you can't cuddle the demons and ask them how their day was. In Half-Life, you can't enter a breakdancing competition against the Combine.
No move. Boom. Try it again. Here we go. Bam. Hey guys, check out my new move.
Even games that are known for being highly immersive and letting you do whatever you want have restrictions. In Red Dead Redemption 2, you can ride up to every NPC and either greet them, insult them, or rob them. You're not able to romance them and have a hot, sweaty makeout session in their tent, rubbing each other's rock-hard bodies with rough, calloused hands as your horses, tied to a stake outside your tent, grow agitated, kicking and throwing their heads back as if able to smell the raw, hot passion hidden away just inside the tent. They want to play a role in this forbidden dance, and their time will come, but for now the two men have the night all to themselves as their cries of passion pierce the sky and their loins froth with... Why aren't you able to do these things? Well, it's simply not possible to program in every possibility, and video games need to draw the line somewhere. You can't cuddle the demons in Doom, you can't...
Too much time, quality, and different priorities, I guess.
You can't beat the Combine with your sick dance moves in Half-Life, and you can't have passionate gay sex in Red Dead Redemption 2, because that's just not what those games are about. Video games can force a certain playstyle on the player in various ways, like through killing you if you're not using cover enough or not moving enough. But really, the most simple and elegant way is to limit what you're actually able to do. Every game wants you to play a certain way. It may want you to be fast, it may want you to be slow, perhaps it wants you to play recklessly or carefully. So, what does Shadow Warrior 2 want from you, the player?
Who, me?
No, the other guy.
How does it want you-
I expected fast gameplay like Doom, I guess.
To approach the combat. Well, judging by the fast movement speed and dashing and double jumps, it's trying to be a fast and chaotic old school shooter.
Yep.
But if that's the case, why are there skills and experience points? Why are there so many long and painful cutscenes? Why are there magic powers? Why can you aim down the sights of your guns? Why does it take so long to reload weapons? Why is there reloading at all? Why is there a hub area between missions that destroys the pacing? Why is there a fucking sprint button? You should be sprinting all the time. All of these gameplay components, separately.
I think sprinting in many games are like really disrupting, especially in something like Halo.
Are fine. The problem is that when you jam every possible game design choice into your game, it becomes muddled and messy. Aiming down sights and having a sprint button in particular serve no purpose in the gameplay. Now there's once again the argument that I could just ignore these parts of the gameplay, but I'm already ignoring the story completely. How many parts of the game do I need to ignore in order to actually enjoy myself? I have the sneaking suspicion that the best way to enjoy this game is to ignore every part of it completely and just not play the fucking thing. It isn't even viscerally satisfying to play. The weapons barely have any impact. This game came out around the same time as Doom 2016, and Doom did not fuck around. There was no reloading, no long-ass cutscenes, no sprint buttons, no aiming down sights. Doom had balls. Shadow Warrior 2 is fronting like it's some badass, but it's a coward. Doom 2016 shrugged off all the gameplay aspects of modern shooters that didn't support the playstyle it wanted. But Shadow Warrior 2 lacked the confidence to separate the wheat from the chaff. It just threw every possible playstyle into its game because it didn't want to scare away Kevin Call of Duty, who can't come if he isn't aiming down iron sights.
Honestly, even if the gameplay had the balls to actually enforce the playstyle it clearly wants from you, the level design is atrocious. They're actually procedurally generated. That's right, they just have an algorithm shit out levels as you play. Here, I'll just show you every map in Shadow Warrior 2. Is this game stupid? Yes. Is that an excuse for it to be lazy?
No!
If you're making something and you don't care because it's stupid, then why the fuck are you making it? What's the point? The fact that you don't care is going to be incredibly obvious in the final product, rendering it about as fun as a puppy holocaust. I've honestly wanted to make this video for a while. When I first started making YouTube videos, I looked through my Steam library to search for games worth talking about and had fucking PTSD flashbacks when I remembered I own this game. Like I said in my last video, I really only talk about games that I'm currently playing, and I've just had so much trouble getting myself to play this game. Every time I thought about playing it again, I had a goddamn panic attack.
I'm gonna kill myself!
Sims got a review. Wow.
I'm going to kill myself and it's your fault!
Okay, I might be exaggerating. It's obnoxious and lacks the strong vision that a game like this would need to work, but I don't like talking about how much I hate it.
Bro, games like these, like, it lets you appreciate things like Doom Eternal much more. It's insane.
Because at the end of the day, at least one of the people that made this game cared about what they were doing. But I had to. Because if it was just bad, I would have let it slide. But I had to say something, because when it came out, the critics loved it. FPS fans, Shadow Warrior 2 is just brilliant, dumb fun. You won't regret investing your time and money in O. In O. This raunchy and a bit outrageous shooter. They say first impression, typo, matters the most. In case, typo, of Shadow Warrior 2, this first impression is terrific.
Okay, alright.
Does it seem like I'm making a mountain out of a molehill? Once again, we come back to, but it's supposed to be stupid. But stupid doesn't equal fun. I love dumb shooters. Every time I quit Shadow Warrior 2 out of boredom, I immediately...
The thing is, this is something you need to play for yourself. It feels great or not when it's too bad, I guess.
We open Painkiller, you know? Hell and Damnation, and I fucking love that game. Look at this thick-ass son of a bitch. It looks like a heavy metal album cover.
Oh, yeah. Damn, boy! He's thick, boy! That's a thick-ass boy! Damn! Bah!
You know what I love about that clip of Fantano screaming about thick-ass boys? It's so sincere, so over the top, and so shamelessly stupid. I think that's why I love Painkiller and Doom and Mad Max Fury Road and John Wick. Being stupid is not impressive, and it's not fun. But being stupid with complete confidence that what you're making will not just be stupid, but truly great? That's something special. Remember earlier when I jammed in that weird can clip from Half-Life 2? Remember how it fit into the flow of the video about as well as I fit into a pair of skinny jeans? That's because it served no purpose. It was barely related to what I was talking about. Maybe you thought it was funny, but it sure as shit
wasn't entertaining, though. Yeah.
Relevant. It didn't help me actually make the point I'm trying to make. It was just some goofy edit I made that sort of maybe could have fit, but clearly didn't. It was just there because I wanted to jam a joke in, because I was scared I'd lose your attention. It was there because I lacked confidence in what I was doing. Flying Wild Hog Studios' lack of confidence in what was clearly their vision is what destroyed this game. That horseback chase scene from John Wick didn't just require hard work from the people making it. It required having the confidence to see it through. You know how I know that? It's because while going to horseback riding lessons and learning to hang off the side of a half-ton animal, Keanu Reeves didn't stop and think, "Wait, this is fucking stupid. Why am I doing this?" He learned to ride that fucking horse because he knew it was gonna be metal as hell. The levels in Shadow Warrior 2 were procedurally generated.
This video got me interested in like any other thing except the game itself.
Because they didn't think spending the time or money to do it the hard way, the right way, was worth it. They included aiming down sights, sprinting, and reloading because they were afraid they'd scare off the average gamer who hadn't played a balls-to-the-wall old-school shooter before. And those cutscenes were obnoxious, loud, and irritating because they were overcompensating for their lack of confidence in their vision. The one aspect of the game that has any level of confidence whatsoever is the story. And you know what's happening the entire time you watch a cutscene? The game is flashing, press any key to skip the whole time.
I hope Shadow Warriors 3 gets better because I have that on my wishes as well. Like, I don't know, man. After seeing this, I'm a bit skeptical about the next iteration.
Seriously, go back and check if you want. It flashes for like 5 seconds, stops for 5, then picks right back up. Over and over again. I think they're embarrassed by this game, and I know why. Being stupid takes courage. It takes guts, balls, and passion.
Remember me?
You can't fake it, Flying Wild Hog. I see you for what you really are. If you're going to be stupid, you fucking do it.
You lick that lead paint. You don't spit on it from 5 feet away like a fucking Democrat. Oh yeah, liberal? You say lead paint is toxic? Then why does it taste so good? Heh. Fucking libtard.
Copyright strike, copyright strike. No.
You
no,
remember
no.
this? It might not be to your taste, but the longest running number one single in US history is a goddamn country
fuck me.
Trap song.
Written I don't want by someone YouTube fuck
who
me.
Was a complete nobody at
Sorry.
The time. A country trap song sounds like a dumb fucking idea, but it's confident. The person making it believed
I'm
it,
so sorry, man.
And it connected with people. But if he watered it down, lost confidence, and just released another fucking...
This is not good, not good, not good. I hope don't YouTube doesn't
recognize
this. Maybe one
line about riding a bull? No one would have given a shit. Do people still talk about Shadow Warrior 2?
Come on.
Fuck no. Sure, it only reviewed 7% worse than Doom 2016. But game critics wouldn't recognize mediocrity if its name was Tom Chick. Is every idea that sounds stupid actually a great idea? No, your idea might actually just be dumb. But if you're brave, and you make that dumb thing that you think deep down might actually be amazing, make sure you put it all on the line. You never know if it'll actually connect with people and have an impact. Doom had an impact, because it didn't pull its punches. Id Software knew what they wanted to make, so they fucking made it.
It was unique and back to the roots, that's why it's nearly perfect.
If you want to do something stupid, either do it or don't. But if you decide to do it, don't falter. Don't hesitate. Don't compromise. Because if you do, people might think you're all right. They might even say you're good.
But they won't think that you're amazing.
But they sure as hell won't remember your name.
Yep. Nothing long-lasting, I guess. Oh, damn. I'm sorry for turning the volume down, but... Damn, I don't want you to fuck me over because of this part. Like, I'm really skeptical about that shit. Like, if they put down, like, OG songs or, like... I don't know, man. But it was a good video. I'm gonna leave a like. This dude is pretty successful, it seems like. And yeah, go support him. Give him the like, give him the sub, give him the comment, and do the same thing to me as well if you wanna support some more reactions. I'm gonna make some Let's Plays in the future, I guess. Like tomorrow, I think. But yeah, that's actually it. I guess see you next time. Wafer out.